started. On the agenda, you'll see where it says that we're going to do the bids last of the workshop, but we're gonna go ahead and do it first. Y'all care to open? We only received two. One was fine trimming, lawn care, the other one is. I'm looking down below. This is NGS, Burchett, okay, Burchett Earthworks. Okay. 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 I have, I'll let you all read them, I was gonna say this one doesn't have insurance attached, but you do have insurance that you could attach, but this one is attached. Okay, we have two, the first one is.
This one's from Fine Trimmings Lawn Care, they're based here in Newport. They have a bid submitted for each individual mowing and trimming the property at $950 per mowing.
Okay, Mickey.
Did you say $950?
Yes, $950.
And Mickey, what was yours?
Okay, mine's from Burchett Earthworks, $750 per mowing.
Okay, so we've got both of those are the only two. So that's the little. Fine Trimmings Lawn Care. We won't vote on that until we get into our meeting, but just in the workshop, so if, does anybody have any questions? Like I said, the only question I had was insurance provided, because this one had insurance in it, but you can provide the insurance copy, that's all we need. So, any questions about the mowing? Because we leave that to the discretion of the director, if it needs, with the rain, if it needs it three times, or on average, we do it twice.
We have in the contract that I can do one extra mowing a year, but like we had this year, it was an unusual rainy type weather, and so I did have them to mow an extra time then too, because it just got like knee high.
Right, we leave that to the discretion of the part of the contract, so.
So we would pay for that, even if it's an addition?
It's an addition to, yes.
Yeah, they don't give it to us for.
No, but it leaves us flexibility, we leave it up to her in the contract that it can be moved around if, again, I think we're calling for rain for the next 7 or 8 days, so if it does that, we may have to add something else. But that's the discretion of the director, so. But that's in the contract whenever who gets it, so we'll go there. Okay, next on the, was that the only thing you needed moved around first?
Yeah.
Okay, because we can't vote on that.
Is it okay if Chad leaves, you wanna stay?
That's what I was saying, if you have any questions.
No, it's all good.
You're good to go, but you're good, thank you. Thank you for coming in. I figure you got daylight, you got stuff you need to get done. Okay, next up is the kids' cooking class, Jean Delisle and Emily.
So first I'm gonna say, I'm sorry, Jean Delisle is the head chef, I'm the sous chef, and she has COVID, bless her heart, so you get second best. Jean started this in summer school, she did, but it was only offered for a week. It was high demand, so she came to me and said, I would really like to continue this through the year as an after-school program. Would you do it with me? I can't do it alone. And I said, absolutely. The life skills they can teach children are just wonderful. So we're gonna take the first quarter and get ready, where you need sponsors and just time to get it ready and get money and supplies and everything ready, a nice, beautiful plan. We're getting people from the community to come in. Ernesto from Monterey comes in, he came in over the summer as well and taught him how to chop tomatoes and lettuce. He's willing to do that again, plus more. Dory McKinney comes and teaches them how to do like iced cupcakes and do all sorts of stuff like that. So we have more ideas too, we wanna get some more people. We thought another one to kind of like talk about how to grow your own foods, kind of gardening, so they can help themselves and help the families too. So, it'll be for three quarters, it'll be offered for 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, 8. So we're asking for the approval for a fundraiser of a hat day, and that's at the end of August. if they, it's gonna be for 12 children, if they wanna do it, so 12 kids per semester, per quarter, sorry. And we're asking that they pay a $15 fee to help with sponsors and supplies as well.
Tell them what you buy, like they buy the apron.
Oh yeah, we wanna get them all aprons and chef hats, and there's pictures. I forgot, I'm sorry, it'll be second best.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
And they have the con, tell them about the contest.
This, yeah, they did like a bake-off, and they, I don't know fully all of this, she did it, I was doing a different, thing. But, these, I guess, were the winners, and so they had taste testers and they did it, they got it.
Yeah, we did, this was the brownies.
Analyzed cheese.
Yeah, this was the brownies, and we had.
It was interesting, to say the least.
Okay, I think, I've got a good idea, we need to reach out to a guy, how do you say his name?
Gary.
Gary.
Okay.
He had, that would be so cool. I need to take this class, so people like adults can.
See, even in summer school, I was like, I wanna be in your class.
When you said you're gonna teach them how to do this, I'm like, I looked at Santa, I was like.
Oh, okay.
But, I mean, he just, he's opened up the restaurant in Pigeon Forge.
Yeah, yeah.
He's got one in Gatlinburg, he's got Guy's Burger, I think we could reach out and say.
Could he not be interested?
Never know.
I would say, hey, you'll reach out.
PR.
So you had the greatest chef cook-off.
Yes, she did.
Wow.
And we're also gonna take, once we make these things, we also have the idea that, you know, we really wanna be in this community, so when they make stuff, we might take it to the hospital, for those who are working, you know, in healthcare, we might take it to, we said like the police officers and the firefighters, because they always come here and help our students too, so we wanna pay back to our community members.
And we've got the greenhouse that.
Yes, absolutely, we talked about that too, if we could incorporate that, so there's Mr. Morrow helping.
Good, that was a good job there, yeah, I enjoyed taste testing.
So, we even talked about, you know, pancakes, eggs, you know, things that, you know, they can make at home if they need to, there's a lot of families that might need that, so life skills are super important.
I wish I had that, I use an air fryer, so.
Well, I wish I had that too, actually.
That's how I fed myself today.
This is a, we decided that it would really be good to offer this enrichment, because a lot of children, I think they would really get involved, plus they do reinforce math and reading during it also, so it's kind of a win-win situation. They are going to ask community people maybe to donate some of the food, because we're going to give them some money, but it was a deluxe program this summer, and we can't afford those deluxe five-star meals all the time. So we're gonna give them a portion, then they're going to ask and have fundraisers for the rest. So
and
we should
really
be able to
take that first quarter and show it in.
Yeah, I could see a brownie selling program going over really well.
Yeah.
After school.
Yeah.
After school.
Like, wait.
They're healthy brownies, right?
Right, right, right.
No calories.
You're supposed to say that after
school. You make those apps, right?
Hey, I can get you some. I can get you some smart snack brownies and you can sell them.
There you go. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Okay, we lost our director.
Well, we'll.
Vicki, your first sub, huh?
Yeah.
Ah, she's pleasant.
So I just, my aunt that is, that's sick, called, and I had to make sure that the voicemail wasn't, that she needed something ASAP, because I thought she'd be able to get CD to her.
Sure, I think that.
I got it. I just had to be able to, if she was sick, I had to get CD to her. Sorry. I think it's great, and like I said, if nothing else, maybe they could just donate like $50 Walmart, Food City card or Walmart card, so you could go to groceries.
I think if they put that out, maybe on our Facebook and Dojo, and maybe in the paper and everything, that we will be surprised how many people will really want to, even $25 cards, you know,
right,
can mount up to really go.
Right, to help with the buying groceries.
With the first 9 weeks, they'll get the plan, and then once we know what they're gonna make, we can try to source the stuff that way, and probably keep them more donated. Like Food City might donate some stuff.
Right.
Money.
Food City or Priceless or Walmart or anybody that might donate the.
People.
Because they like free advertisement too.
You know, the new CTE stuff could fall underneath that somewhere down the road, because that's something I think they're trying to do at the high school.
Right, they're doing a whole wing, they've added culinary to that.
And hopefully by our next meeting, CTE, we're gonna have some information about what direction we're gonna take for the innovative grant you know, maybe classes would offer for the sixth grade, then the seventh grade, then the eighth grade. More to come.
Sounds great. Any questions on that, guys? Thank you. Okay, Michelle, you got your it?
All right, Michelle, moving from CTE to CDC. New guidelines came down the pike, I think it was Thursday, if I'm not mistaken, and main, from what I can muddle through, you know how clear they usually are. Positive people still stay out 5 days, masked 10. The big difference is if you have been exposed, and as far as I can understand, the people that have been exposed are cut loose with masks for 10 days. So, major things, there were some things that really didn't apply, it was that no need to do the test to stay, we didn't do that anyway. They did say less social distancing, that sort of thing. Vaccinated and unvaccinated people does not matter now. So if I have a spouse, let's say her husband's tested positive, she can come, whether she's been vaccinated or not, or he vice versa. So that's thrown out the window on that, make our life a little easier, because it's very awkward to try to ask somebody, have you been vaccinated? How many have you had? So that was a biggie. That's the main thing I got from it. Candy, do you have anything to add?
Page after page.
Yeah, I mean,
lots of little words just to say that.
Just to say that.
Did you say if they were positive,
if
they were out 5 days and then they wore a mask
five days? Five more.
Okay, to be
yes.
A total of 10.
Yes. And then if they are exposed, they come with a mask for 10 days.
And they monitor for symptoms?
Yeah, monitor for symptoms. There's a clause in there about testing on
day five.
Days
five and seven.
Six and then eight, blah, blah, blah. It's to not wear a mask or to wear a mask. So
and we still have the kids, Dr. Kathy,
mm-hmm.
down there
mm-hmm.
that we could do some if they wanted us to.
I think you have to have, if they do choose to test, not to wear a mask. They have to do that on two particular days, 5 and 7 or
and
6 and 8.
6 and 8.
And at that point, I don't know. I mean, for me, I think that's harder to try to monitor and take care of, but we'll do what you want us to do.
Right. Well, this, like I said, the guidance I got, and I guess I'm the one that kind of instigated. I got this August 11th, so I immediately sent it to Michelle and to Sandy, and just said that, you know, this is what they've come out with at 3 p.m. on Thursday afternoon. There was an email before I left on Monday afternoon that says, this could possibly be changing again this week. And it listed healthcare, and it listed K through 12, and then it just said general gym pop. So I don't know what changes are going to be coming down, considered to the general population, to the K-12, to the healthcare, like we discussed. With me working in healthcare, we're considered essential workers. I come to work. I put on a mask, I put on a KN95 or an N95, and I have come to work. Teachers were not listed as essential, so they're not mandated, but within the guidelines of what healthcare falls under. But this still opens it up that as long as if they're not the positive person, they're supposed to come with a mask on.
It did say high quality.
High quality mask, and I don't know if that's referring, does it state that it says KN95 or N95? But an N95 mask, you have to properly wear an N95 mask, you have to be fit and tested.
But you have to see it off.
You have to be fit tested by a healthcare professional to wear an N95. I mean, that's to be certified to wear an N95. I say that because I'm certified, you know, I actually fit test I would say 85% are Smoky Mountain Home and Hospice. Every new employee comes through me and we fit test. So to wear the N95s, they are considered a respirator, and they, to wear one of those and to be certified, you are to be fit tested by a healthcare professional. The KN95s are the ones that you can buy. Of course, you can get N95s as well. The difference between the two, you want to be able to tell them, is the KN95s will go around your ears, the N95s go over your head, and that's where it's supposed to be fitted. You know, there's a lot of people out there that are wearing N95s, but I would dare say they've been fit tested.
What we may need to do is, and I don't know if you get any money for that or not, if we maybe had some of the KN95s, because they're really a higher quality than cloth masks, to just make it optional. If you know someone, I don't know if you would like to do that or not.
Well, I don't know.
Are they hard to get like they were?
Do they make a kid's KN95? We just ordered more. We spent every last penny.
They do, but they have a different name.
They do have a name. But the thing is if they come in, they don't necessarily come in small, medium, or large,
yeah,
like the N95s do. Because, I've got some pretty small people. I refer to them as smurfs. And that's what you would need. And that's some of those green. Kathy, I know you've seen them, those green. Bold looking. And I do have to have some of my people fit with those because they fit the smaller, slender faces. I've never had that problem, but I have some people that do. But they have to have those. I've jokingly said that if they could get them on the internet, there'd be people walking around in those Packers. They'd have on the hoods, the mask, and the little battery pack on the back, and they'd be talking like, we'd be having our own little Grey's Anatomy walking around, and if people could get them, I know they would. But I have handed out, while we're on this, I've handed out, and Kathy, I
can share.
You share with her, because I don't know that I have another one. I have given out some information, and I gave it to all the board. I meant to get this to you ahead of time, guys, but I did not get the chance. I've been out of town on training, and then we had a small little medical emergency this weekend with my little 8-month-old grandson. We got to spend our first days at Children's Hospital with respiratory concerns and heart rate and breathing concerns. So this is something it's called Active Pure Technology. I do have a representative here, but with us not being able to have looked at this and reviewed it, I want everybody to be able to chance to look at this. If you have some questions after you've reviewed it, if you would compile them for me, send them to me, email or text, and I will get with Mr. Eddie and take care of that. I've tried to get it on front backs for you, some information on that. I'm not sure, again, I'm not even talking with him on pricing, so it would be something that I need you to actually look at and review.
Can I interrupt for a minute about this? I read over what you gave out, and we have those already. Do you see the Metafly that we bought $37,000?
So we have something like that already?
Yeah, on August the 9th of 2021, we advertised with all of the listed things that pretty much is what yours has, and we spent you all wrote it on $37,000.
Right, I remember those, and that
classroom that has the
and each one of the classrooms have that.
Mm-hmm.
And then we still have our sprayer.
Yes,
that we go around and we spray. That's like a backpack sprayer. Is that, if I'm
mm-hmm.
not,
we bought several of those.
But we have that can go into
the foggers.
And that was the next thing I was going to talk about, is the fogger that we can take into the pod. We can go into the classroom, we put it in the classroom, shut the door, it fogs it, and we can also close off and do the common area of the pod. So, but I had just spoken with Mr. Eddie with this, and I, you know, again, I want us to make sure that we've got the latest and the greatest in what we're doing. We've done what we can actually physically do to keep everybody here safe as possible with those, because those clean a room area, a surface area, quite handily. So, but just so that we know, you know, we talk about, we have had the updates. We're doing everything here that we can possibly do for our staff and students.
I'll just reiterate too that they still mentioned reinforcing hand washing, which we're continuing to do. They mentioned the high quality mask, improving ventilation, and we do that, okay? And then the distance, we're supposed to be pretty much wide open as far as I can tell. So those are just the last key things that I got out of it. So we'll follow CDC with this if you're good with that, or if you have any suggestions, changes, open to whatever you. We actually, I was in Kingsport at a coordinated school health meeting today, got a little bit of information up there, not this specific, but Nurse Kathy kept up with some COVID stuff. And we're not having a lot, it's just coming in steady. But, you know, at this point, we have somebody positive, they're going to be out 5 days. So I told her just to tell them I would contact them tomorrow and I'll give instruction with return dates. And as far as the homework and stuff, I mean, you get one on a Saturday, you know, they're going to be back in 3 days, so, or four. But, so, you know, I've still been going through the distance to make sure they're excused with the provided positive result that I get. I am accepting screenshots because home tests are the big thing, and I'd rather get that than nothing at all. So you tell me what you want me to do, change, or whatever.
Well, I mean, with the home tests, we're even doing that in healthcare.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's a lot of our people, you know, we went on and ordered those,
mm-hmm.
and we just have to screenshot it and send it in to HR. With, I mean, if you go to the doctor, of course, but if you just do the home test, you've got to screenshot the positive test and what kind of test it is.
And most of them, I'll say this round, it seems like it's pretty light. I have had one or two that turned into COVID pneumonia. So the one that I know specifically is on day 12. So, at that point, you're just kind of when they can make it back. And then you're immunocompromised, so took care of some of that this week. So, I mean, I think we're in fairly good shape. So, everybody looks at me, tries to read my face, and I'm like, I'm happy.
Smile and nod.
We're not stressed
smile and nod.
Not stressed yet.
So we're going to vote to follow the CDC guidelines? Is that what we're doing?
Well, I mean, that's what we're doing.
We're putting a little bit of a mask mandate back in.
No,
we're
saying
that. I know
we're
not saying mask mandate, but we're doing a mask mandate based on the CDC guideline here. And I just want to, I'm for that, but I'm for what the CDC says. I'm just trying to pay, you know.
We're just saying after a positive test, for you to come back after day 5, you've got to wear a mask for
just
5 more days.
We're
going to
do that today.
Just for that person, not for everybody around that
so
person.
So will we have to do that by policy?
We've been doing that.
Mm-hmm.
So we're just still following. Yeah, we say every day that we're just following CDC, and it's on our website. We're following CDC recommendations.
Just making sure we're doing our
own thing. I think so far
people
understand. I don't think they've given you any, resistance to it.
Mm-hmm.
And they're glad to get back, you know.
Exactly.
Because it's been a milder type.
Well, they're happy to get back after the 5 days. And, you know, I've even had parents speak to me and say, mine's going to wear it for 10 more. I said, well, I'm requesting they wear that for the 5 days they return.
I guess the scenario I'm thinking of is you have a positive case in this room tonight, we should all have a mask on for 10 days. That's what you got to think about. So classroom environment with no CDC separation. So boom, that whole classroom need mask on for 10 days along with the teacher.
feel like I was.
I know, it's gonna get complicated is what I'm saying here, I'm just thinking out loud here, I'm not, you know, trying to make it harder on anybody, but based on the guidelines here, that's what we're doing.
They don't really have a choice in the matter, it is federal government.
The positive person has to wear.
Can't do anything about that.
Says a contact person, based on what she just said, I mean, I'm.
And it said watch for symptoms, and I'm gonna be honest, I mean, I think we're exposed every day when we walk through Food City, Walmart, go out to a restaurant. I mean, and I'm totally not saying anything one way or the other, but I'm just saying, I think we're exposed every day.
Agreed.
Just like you said, we're probably exposed to somebody right now, we don't know, but hopefully within 48 hours.
But once you do know, Michelle, then you have to kinda kick in this CDC, you know, implement the policy, so. I know it's gonna be a slippery slope for everybody this year, it's gonna be hard, it's gonna be tough. And we'll be right here with you, hopefully, we should have some kind of trigger mechanism, though, when we see that it's out of control, that we just go ahead and kick it in and say, hey, mask mandate everybody.
I think what we probably would do, if we really realized that, we would contact the board and have a call meeting to kinda reassess where we were on the status of the cases in our school community.
Well, and we did that last year, I mean, if you'll think about it, we got real creative with the days that, if it were a weather day, and it was a Friday or a Monday, and our numbers were up, we took that weather day.
We bought more Clorox wipes for everybody, isn't it 1,500 in a container? And, like, we can spray, we have a lot of things we can kick in.
Yeah, we saw every teacher, every teacher in the building has a thermometer, they can use it if they need to.
And we still have hand sanitizer as you enter, we've moved it outside the door, cause it takes the wax off when it hits a floor, so we moved it out.
Happy season, not good tomorrow.
Good tomorrow, but, I mean, I think there's things that we're doing on a routine basis that we can, in the words of Emeril Lagasse, kick it up a notch if we have to. We can, you know, we can step it up and do it more often if we need to than what we're doing regularly.
Our teachers are savvy at knowing how to look for now, I think more so.
Well, they've had to learn it, they've had to get used to.
Channels, don't you think they are, and send people down to the academy, that's.
Kind of like that motherly instinct, you can tell ahead of time.
I mean, I also, and I'm, I don't want you to feel like I'm jumping toward you, but I also wanna say that, you know, and Justin did bring this up too. You know, if we're in this room, I'm probably gonna be more worried about Mr. Short and maybe who's behind me and beside of me, as far as, you know, if I might have truly been exposed rather than you guys. And from my experience, that's pretty much how it's played out. But, and then not always. I was in a car with 6 people coming back from Alaska. I know we were all exposed at one point because my husband was not well. We had no way to get the test and check in. 3 turned out positive, 3 did not.
Nature of the beast. I guess what I'm trying to get everybody to start thinking about is that you're gonna have that load on you again.
No.
You're gonna have to find out where that student was at all day, and how many people was he near for, is it 15 minutes? Inside 6 feet, is that the number still?
Well, the health department's saying we don't do that.
So we're not doing any of that, but the guidelines say if you're contacted, you're supposed to be in a mask for 10 days. If that person's positive, which would be that whole classroom. So I just wonder if we, you know, we buy into this, you know, we might be preparing ourselves, maybe looking at, I'm not saying this won't work, I'm saying it's gonna be a lot harder on you guys than it was before. Before, does everybody put a mask on, like it or lump it, get out? Now we're going, you're gonna have to decide and choose individual classrooms and trace that student down all day long. Where was he at? Whose basketball did he touch? A lot more complicated for you, Michelle.
It is, you're right.
So, you know, good.
If they tell us.
Godspeed and good luck.
But see, I mean, they threw out the contact tracing, so it's literally just the person that's positive.
They threw that out, yeah.
It's the person that's positive, there is no contact tracing.
It's only the positive, right? It's just the.
But I thought it said in there, if you were in contact with the positive person.
I think that probably is household.
Just if you were.
I mean, no, I'm not saying that, I'm saying you look at somebody in a household, and if that, you know, somebody in that household is positive, that the others can come to work, to school, whatever, with a mask.
As long long as they're not showing symptoms.
As long as they're not, they're asymptomatic.
Asymptomatic.
And I always instruct, when I get a call, you watch for the slightest symptom. And if the slightest symptom, you test or you stay home, let's get, you know, check to make sure. I'm not, I mean, I'm just interpreting how I, how I did, that's how I took it.
And that's how I interpreted it from you, that we, that if you were in contact with somebody that had COVID, your guidance should have been 10 days in a mask.
But more than likely, in a classroom, you're probably not gonna have anybody, I mean, they may or may not call me.
I understand, it just, I just trying to think to where you'll end up at, about midstream here, and none of this is to say I'm not for it, I'm all for any kind of things that protect us, I'm just trying to make sure you don't have a, plan that's gonna fail before you ever get started. But that clarifies it some, so you're not saying if one of us have it, he sit here beside me for 15 minutes, he doesn't have to do anything.
He could call you, or he might call you, he might not.
So basically, we're doing, so I'm just, I mean, so in a classroom, you're gonna have that same question.
You observe for symptoms, but you, don't we send the one home that has it, or?
The positive.
Yes, and then the others, you observe symptoms, you know, watch for symptoms.
They let you know at the first symptoms. We don't send, now, we did send them home way back.
A long time.
But even in the last year, we weren't sending them.
What I think CDC has learned a lot through the pandemic, and kind of loosened up somewhat to realize what did work or what showed to be more effective.
Well, like they said, they're looking to, at now they know treatments, they got vaccinations out there, so they're, I don't know.
It says recommended is that instead of quarantining, if you've been exposed to COVID-19, you're to wear a high quality mask for 10 days and get tested on day 5. That's much harder than you just telling everybody to wear a mask. Not that we'd ever get a mask mandate back to again against anybody's best judgment.
I don't know if we could ever back up to that.
It's just, like you say, positive thoughts would be that this does not turn into, a bad storm.
Trust me, I will call somebody and say, I'm going down to tell. Get too big.
Overlap this.
And Jan, I got a text back that, someone that was using, his version of KN95, that listed as KN94s. Yeah.
I don't know that.
Yeah, I don't know that that's official, maybe that's what they recommend. KN94.
I mean, I could check at the office to see if we could.
Oh, the kids version.
I mean, I know you don't have them, they sent just regular surgical masks and those cloth ones. So, I mean, I don't know.
From China.
Yeah, you gotta get them from China, which who gave us this crap, but that's okay. But, and if you want them, they're on a container still out in the ocean. But, okay. Ms. Christina, cafeteria report, let's have some good news.
Well, the good news is we're all eating together, so it's much easier. Hopefully it stays that way, let's cross our fingers. Our numbers are down, obviously, I knew that was gonna come into effect with going back to applications. Everybody has a 30-day grace period based on what you qualified last school year. So you've got 30 days to get your application in. So the ones that were free or reduced last year will have the first 30 days, and then they'll have to submit an application within that timeframe. Whatever they qualify as the date that I process is what they roll out with. So either they qualify as the same, or their status changes to either full pay or reduced if they were free or went from reduced to free this school year. So every day and every night, that's what I work on. I've got right now, I think I've got 136 applications processed. Now, there'll be more. That's not including who's directly certified to the state, so that's completely separate. So I'm continuing to work on processing the applications, printing out the letters, getting them to the teachers. That way the teachers can send them home with the students. That way they know if for some reason they were reduced last year and their income is higher and their status has changed, they know effective the date that letter is you know, what their status is going to be, or vice versa if it's gone the other way. We're in the process of training a new cook. We've hired a new cook down there. She's doing a really good job. It is a learning process. The cooking part of it, I will say, is not hard. But the paperwork that the state requires, that's the tricky part. So, she's coming along really good. I work with her every day, cooking throughout the day, and then spend every afternoon with her to get the paperwork done. So, she's doing a good job. We also have Mr. Short and Mr. Morrow in the cafeteria daily. Mr. Short has the younger kids and Mr. Morrow has the younger kids and Mr. Short's in there with the older kids to help out. We're in the process of hiring 2 part-time people to help out, because just with everybody in there, regardless if we were in 1 cafeteria or 2 cafeterias, you would, with that many kids in there at one time, especially the little ones, it takes more than one person.
It took one visit for me to
realize
we needed help.
Yeah. You know, and I've had to work her out for this whole week. So, I literally have come in every morning at 6 and then done that breakfast whole part, the vegetable part, and then was working on the serving line every single day. So I, you know, I try to assist when I can. If we don't have kids coming to the line, you know, I'm over there opening ketchup packets or, you know, milk cartons or, you know, just whatever it is to try to help, but I can't be, you know, can't be out there the entire time. I take all my work home with me, do my grocery order, do everything at night because I don't have time during the day to do it. We are making it work, but I do think with having the 2 people to come in, you know, just for the 2 hours that they're in there for lunch to come in to help would be a huge, huge help. That way, you know, if there's a discipline problem or whatever, they can, you know, tend to that, and then we have help, you know, just going around. I will start sending out charge letters home to the students tomorrow. So everything, every application that's come through, I have 1 application in my mailbox right now, and it's not complete, so I can't process that anyway. But every application that has come through the cafeterias, my mailbox here, or been put directly on my desk has been processed. So anybody that still is charging is going to get a letter, because I don't know if they don't know. I don't know how they wouldn't know. But in the event they don't know that it goes back to, you know, paying, they will know when they get my little love letter sent home, which, you know, I don't know how else to do it. But right now, we're like $380 in the negative with just charges. So, you know, I've tried to get everything through and everything processed as fast as I can. And like I said, this is day 5, and it's taken me up until today to get everything processed and sent out. So everybody should know where they're at. We do still have several people that are on the grace period. Obviously, it goes the first 30 days. So they still have time to get, you know, their application in. So I just, it's just going to be a steady flow of applications coming in daily and then just getting the process as quick as I can to see where they're at. Our numbers are down, but that's to be expected. Right now, pre-K and kindergarten, they're on a staggered start, so we have very few of those right now coming in. I ran the numbers just from the 9th through today, and we're averaging about 200 for breakfast, which is pretty much where we were last year. It's good, but it's universal free breakfast, so everybody eats free. There's no charge. The lunch, we are down. We're down about 150, you know, so we're just trying to boost our a la carte as, you know, as best we can. And I know we have some limitations by grade levels, which hurts, but we just, you know, follow through whatever they say. Kindergarten doesn't allow any a la carte just because there's not enough time to eat it. Now first grade, they were allowed in first grade, but now they're not allowed until Friday. So we're trying to get as creative as we can, but as they start taking away, I don't really know what else, you know, we can do. But we're trying the best we can. The full price meal is $2.50 for students a day. So it was $2.35. It did go up, but the cost of food, chemicals, cleaning, everything has, you know, I mean, just you would know going to the grocery store. The cost of everything has increased, and it's just got to trickle down. You know, our delivery fee has gone up. It's just the domino effect. So, you know, we're here every day. Our main concern is making sure the kids are fed. That they get a breakfast and they get a lunch. It doesn't matter if they have money in their account or not. They're not even, you know, they're just said, bring some money. You know, if you come in and you charge a meal, hey, try to bring some money tomorrow. We don't make it, you know, obvious or anything like that, but they're going to get fed one way or another. So we've just been charging and letting them go through. So that's where we're at. And again, we have the share table, which we've had, you know, for a few years, that share table, which is huge. And we're going to continue to keep that and feed the kids.
Well, I'm going to get up, and first of all, I wanted to share some good news with you. I'm going to get up because I can't see where my So Justin put together this PowerPoint presentation for me when I met with the teachers and staff. And as you know, we've been building things together, whether it's the facility doing construction there or building academically and going up with it. So we were really excited when we got the results of our test scores because we knew the teachers had set goals, they'd made plans. They got to work, they stuck with it, and they reached their goals. But I do want to say this. You know, the teachers worked really, really hard. But I don't want us to also forget our support staff, too, in the administration, because it's really all of us working together to get us on this path. But I think we had some really excited teachers and staff when we met the other day because what we saw school-wide literacy. We got a 5 in school-wide literacy. That's as high as you can get. In school-wide numeracy, we got a 5 in school-wide numeracy. That's as high as you can get. School-wide science, we got a 5. Another top. School-wide social studies, we got a 5. So, school-wide composite, we got a 5. This is as good as you can get. Rarely do you school-wide composite, we got a 5. This is as good, as I say, as you can get. You rarely hear of schools or systems getting it 2 years in a row. But it just shows, I think, how everyone's worked together. The teachers have worked really, really hard. The support staff, the administration, everybody's come together. And so, as you saw on your paper, you could pretty well tell what I was going to be asking for, that I hope that you all will approve that the ones that do get a T-ball score that had a 5 get a $1,000 supplement, the ones that had a 4 get $800 supplement minus benefits, and then everybody, the whole staff, would have the option of getting 2 personal days or taking $300 minus benefits. And the plan is, it's hard to redo a plan that appears to be working. But the encouragement that I gave to the teachers, I think they've seen that looking at data has helped to drive their instruction. I told them to stick with checking out the benchmark and Ames Webs to see where areas that students may have that they could grow and move forward in. Because we'll have to work even a little harder this year to make show and help close the gap so we can continue to make a 5. It gets harder every year when you've made it the year before. I had a superintendent to call me when at first they turn out the percentages that people can say, you know, how many were on mastery level and things like that. And he called me and said, I want to know what you all are doing at Newport Grammar School. He said the percentages are so high. And what I told him that our teachers were data-driven. And I know we use that word so frequently, but it is the truth. And I believe that all of our teachers, no matter what grade level that they teach in, they believe their grade level is just like this brick wall, as important as any other grade building the wall to make it a solid foundation. And I think that we can say that our teachers, plus the support staff, plus the administration are all on the same path. We want to turn out productive citizens and a good project, and that's the students. I think as administration, I think we've talked, one of the biggest things we can do as a board and as an administration to our teachers and to our staff is to continue to offer encouragement, to be their cheerleaders, and we need to make available resources. And I think they would have to say all they have to do is ask. And we provide resources if they ask for them. And we need to let them know that we have their backs and that we're there for them. And I told them to just keep laying that solid foundation, that it pays off. We have seen it. And we're really proud of them, and I think they were proud of themselves. There were a lot of smiles. Because the ones, you're always uptight till you get those scores. You think, well, I think the kids did really well from the benchmarks at Ames Webb. but you really don't know until they really come forth. But I think the board I know is really proud of the teachers and the, all of our staff, because as I say, it's hard to make it 2 years in a row. Now I'll sit down and go over my other stuff here that I wanted to discuss with you. I wanted to say we're really excited about the Charlotte Jones Mims Clinic may become a reality, David, because Michelle and Kathy and I are going to meet with Newport Pediatrics. I think I've worked a deal out to get a pediatric nurse practitioner maybe 2 hours a day, and then I'm working with Candy Overhope to get maybe an adult nurse practitioner to come maybe 1 or 2 hours daily. So I have found out that if you're with certain organizations and you're a nurse practitioner, you can only deal either with pediatrics or with adults. So I think they're going to work with me so we can get it together, and they'll be working in the clinic. Plus, our mental health person that we have from Allied has started, hasn't she? And that's a real big plus. I think our teachers really appreciated us having that for the children. Next time, if possible, at our board meeting afterwards, I'd like to take our board on a trip to our third grade bathrooms to let you all see. You all won't believe it, how nice they really look. The teachers are so impressed, and the kids are really impressed. Of course, they're really impressed with that automatic hand towel thing that just keeps giving it to you as you're holding your hand under there. But our windows are moving quicker than they were moving. I think they're wanting to move forward and move to other projects. So now they have it in higher gear and moving on. I really think maybe the one that I've had Holston Construction maybe wants to move on away from me. So he's trying to hurry up and get it done, because I'm up here on the weekends texting what they need to be doing and stuff like that. And Sean Ellison now just say, just tell me what you want and everything. So that works really well for me. As Christina said, we hired we're going to hire two part-time monitors for 2 hours a day. When I went down there and saw Mr. Short, Mr. Morrow really hustling and working hard, I decided that it would help out if we freed up some of their time to do some of the more discipline-wise aspect of it, and have some monitors that would assist them with opening meal, opening kitchen, doing things like that. So I think that will work out and give them some relief also. Roof phase one is coming to being completed pretty soon. They're putting on the guttering. But what's going to really be nice is after they've done these windows and gotten them into Robin Lane's and Amy Hammonds' room, because they had to put the beams in there. Now we're ready for the big awning to come in. They're going to take the old awning down that looks like Carabas with plants growing on top of it. We're going to take that down and put a really large awning that's going to cover the shop too, so Bobby and them don't have to get out in the rain if they're going into the building. So that's coming down the pike. I gave you in your thing about kind of like an overview to tell you about where the window was progressing and things. And our teachers have really been troopers in changing to different locations, because they know it's short-lived. And then Kathy, the clinic's really going through a whole makeover, and I think it's really going to be nice. We have to wait on her cabinets to be put together before she can be back in there. But all of that is coming together. I talked to Bill Vinson, and I'm asking him to start drawing up plans for our playground. I'm hoping to put around from $450,000 to $500,000 in it, and that should get us a pretty good playground. And then after that, we'll step back, reassess our funds, and move forward. And that's about all that I have to say, unless y'all got some questions for me. I've decided I may do this moonlight and on construction. I go to work for Tim. Do you think Tim means anybody else?
Which guy
David, I can help you out with that.
Help you out, David.
There may be a position open.
Yeah. I've decided these men, the other day, I'm just saying it's funny. They were putting in the concrete, the Wasco plant out here, people, and filling up, you know where the stair rail is going up to fourth grade from third. Anyway, well, they were there, and I said, could I go up those steps, because I wasn't sure if they were allowing people. He looked at those other people, he said, this is the boss, she can go wherever she wants in this building. And I thought, Betty, I didn't even know he even knew who I was, but I have a feeling they may be talking about me behind the lines, but anyway. Here she is.
Like the deal.
But it's been fun to see a lot done. I mean, it's really been fun and rewarding to me. But that's about all. Can't you tell I get excited when I talk about this?
You still see that kindergarten teacher, can't we, guys? I have to say, you can tell.
Uh-huh.
You know,
it's coming along. It's really, it's going to be good. I'll shut up. That's about it, I have to say.
It's to be commended what she's done.
I agree, because
but it's been fun.
Staying on top of it has had to been a, I mean, it's been a feat in itself of trying to keep them, like you said, their feet to the fire, getting it done correctly, not signing off on it until it is done and done correctly.
Well, I was texting the one that's doing bathrooms. I was Saturday at night. I was texting, sitting on that black bench. I bought for the bathroom in there. I was texting, these handles will not pass my inspection. I do not want old handles. I want all new handles. I want them matching the handles and everything. Then I started, and this part, I do not. I bet he thought, does she never get away from this place? Because I was just texting.
She's alive. She's still there.
Yeah.
Well, you got a hard act to follow.
Well, yeah. On top of all that that she's been talking about, we started school last week.
Wow. By the way,
yeah,
right?
Not to forget that, but we had our first 4 days last week, started our first full week this week, and I have to say one of the things that's kept me awake at night the last couple of weeks is knowing that all that construction is going on at the same time that we have kids in the building, and that's been a little dance act that we've done. That the teachers have done really well. All of the construction that's going on in third and fourth grade right now with these windows has resulted in some teachers' classrooms being relocated to the library or to some other rooms that aren't having windows replaced yet. So we've displaced some teachers. We've had them move their classes. They met their classes in places they normally don't meet. And they have worked very hard in preparing for that, moving furniture, moving supplies, asking if it's safe to go into a room that has metal posts holding the roof up over their heads. There were some hair-raising moments, but they made that work. In fact, a couple of teachers, she mentioned Robin Lane and Amy Hammonds, moved back into their rooms starting today. Their windows are in, the rooms are clean, and they were able to get back inside. So we still have a couple of rooms that are in the process of having some work done. But as she said, they're moving very quickly. And
the custodians are working hard, too, to get those rooms cleaned up. So they can move back.
You could see a before and after of some of those rooms with no ceiling tiles and junk in the floor and just everything thrown everywhere. And you look at the picture after they've cleaned it, it's immaculate. They're thankful to be back in their rooms. And again, they're to be commended because of all the work getting the kids to and from these alternate places and getting their supplies moved and put back in place after they've been returned. So lots of nice things there. She mentioned the cafeteria. It is nice to be back in one place. Christina's already gone. It's nice logistically to have everybody in one room again. That's where Mr. Morrow needs some praise because he's developed the schedule to get people in and out of there, logistically to get all of the people seated and all the people dismissed on a schedule so that we can keep the flow going, get everybody finished in 2 hours. It's tight, but it works so that we have areas that can be cleaned while other kids are coming in to eat. Don't want to say that it's chaos down there. There are a lot of kids down there, but it was sort of that way before COVID. We've returned to that. So lots of progress there as well. I noticed for myself this morning when I went into the gym just how much new lighting makes a difference in there.
LED, I forgot to mention, we had all LED
lights. We do indeed have LED lights in the gym, and you'll need sunglasses when you go in down there because it's...
And Lisa's, did you all notice out here as you came in, those are new LED lights.
Yes. Very nice lighting down there. Very, very good work. Kids, every kid that walked in the door, their eyes go, what is all this? Where did this light come from? So that looks nice. It's just in time for volleyball season. We at our volleyball season tournament on Saturday, by the way, where we were champs. We defeated three other schools and are off to a great start on our season. In fact, they're playing tonight at, I think, at Smoky Mountain. We also have some home matches Tuesday and Thursday this week to kick off the season here at school. Good things going on there too. Bodes well athletically for what we've got happening.
Competitive team this year, didn't they say we got
yes,
competitive
very
team?
Competitive team. I mean, we were very strong this Saturday. Very strong. So happy about that. I'm planning a little surprise for staff on Friday that I won't mention here, but I'm going to announce it on Wednesday. Just a little recognition for getting off the ground this first couple of weeks and getting things off and moving. So we'll have a little treat for staff, faculty on Friday around lunchtime. So looking forward to that, and it's been a good 2 weeks. That's all I have.
A couple things. Began working on the Save Schools, Save Act budget. We'll work on getting that ready for you next month. It's not changed as far as monetarily. It's about $15,000. I'll work with Mrs. Burchard on seeing exactly how much we need to work on the vestibule up there for Lisa. That's kind of our top priority. We carried over some money from last year, so it's got to be done by Christmas. So we'll take that money with this year's money. And she worked a couple weeks ago. They talked about it. They spec'd it out. So that'll be coming down the pipe soon for you guys probably to look at. We are retraining a lot of routines. You know, a lot of things are going back to pre-COVID. A lot of our pickup, dismissal, lunch, some of that stuff we've tweaked because of COVID, and we've kept some of the procedures, and then we've added some new stuff, so we're kind of trying to get everybody retrained here this first week or so. Like at breakfast, you know, we're going back to backpacks at the back, and then kids sitting by grade level, where before it was just kind of a cluster because they were going in and out, going to the gym, but everybody's back in the cafeteria, and we're doing that in hopes of getting those breakfast numbers up because it's free, so we can push everybody to get breakfast. And whether they want it or not, we can say, go get some breakfast. And usually when a kid walks in and they see breakfast, and even if they've eaten, they'll go get a Pop-Tart, they'll get something. So we're keeping that going, but it's been a challenge. The teachers have been great to help, just getting kids back to the routines of that kind of stuff, while also keeping in mind health and safety. You know, we talked a lot about, I did my grade level presentations with my little kids, my first to fourth grades, and we talked about, you know, keeping hands out of mouth, not coughing on people, covering our cough, you know, staying out of the personal space, things that you think would go without saying, but after watching them for a day, need to be covered. Because we're not wearing as many masks, and we'll make sure people stay as healthy as possible. But like I said, you know, making sure that we get them here, get them fed, and get them home. Those are the big three. I call those the big three areas, you know, the arrival, lunch, and dismissal. That's what I focus a lot of time on in the summer. In the summer, trying to get the plans together, making sure that our families know the plans. We've had a few issues, people wanting to walk up and get their kids. That's a big safety thing. We don't want parents walking up, so we've had to kind of turn some people away. And there's a few that have special permission, but we try to keep people in their cars and keep them moving. It took us 2 days this past week to get everybody moving. Usually it takes us about 2 weeks. So we are back to normal times after 2 days. So a big shout out to our parents and our students for getting in, listening, getting to their cars, and getting home. And that's all I've got, unless you have any questions about any of our procedures that you've heard about.
One of you two out with your radio on head saying so and so. I like that. That helps keep everyone moving. Amy,
we had a wonderful professional development week. We ended the week with a hayride around the community with our teachers in Western wear and costumes with signs and bells and whistles and music, celebrating our return back to school. We did have some sponsors that I want to publicly thank for in-service week. We had Newport Nutrition who made a special drink for us that week and who provided some incentives for teachers that week.
Yeah.
No, I'm talking about the discounts that they gave us. I also also, wanna thank Organic Needs Massage. We had a massage therapist who came to the school on our teacher work day and offered our teachers massages, 15-minute massages that they loved. We plan on having them back again in a month or so for the teachers to enjoy again. We want to thank, of course, the board for sponsoring a breakfast day, our Newport City Education Association, Cock County Business Women's Club, Memorial Baptist Church, Lincoln Avenue Baptist Church, Lowland Credit Union, Faith Fish, Modern Woodman. All of those people helped out with snacks, goodies, breakfasts for our teachers. Hollis Emmons brought horses and a practice roping thing so that our teachers could actually have a roping contest. Mr. Beston Morrow may have won the roping contest.
Watch out.
We also need to thank Dustin. He pulled the teachers around in his truck. Sean Messer donated the wagon. Matthew Woody donated the hay for the hay wagon. Connor Burchett donated the time to place all of the hay on the hay wagon, off the hay wagon, and deliver the hay back to the co-op.
And took photos
of the faculty all day, and taught some roping to the.
He taught me, and I just.
And won the contest.
He's got a future in teaching.
So we had a great week that week for all of that. Today we started calling around to the teachers on checking on all the kids in our whole building, making sure that all our children have the necessary supplies and things that they need to have to come back to school and be successful in the classroom. So I'm checking on backpacks, crayons, pencils, whatever we need to make sure that children have. But we're starting to contact rooms to make sure that they have all those things that they need. And then we'll start budget amendments here, and we'll get those budget amendments pretty soon once those are finished. So busy as usual in supervisor's office.
I had my niece come up and give you a lesson on goat time. She does goat time and barrel racing and poles.
Oh, there was, I will tell you, right, Seth Butler, there was a lot of trash talking going on down at the
rodeo. She checks her rodeos. Her mom was on scholarship at UT Martin, and she was a barrel racer. And so Josie's looking to follow those footsteps. She does. Like I said, go time.
I think we need to commend Amy and Pam Vernon for putting a lot of time into planning fun things that the teachers seem to really like and enjoy. And I think they've already got a theme
for next year. I've already started.
I have to say kudos to that too, because I mean, I know one of the COVID years you had the things you lay on the.
Oh,
work under a car.
Hippo.
They played the game with the Hungry Hippo, and had the teachers laying on those creepers, and they were running them out there, and they had to grab the balls and run them back.
We did have a second annual cornhole tournament, and we had the same winners. Caleb Warren, I think Provincial won the second year in a row. But that gets competitive, and we have teams, and they dress alike that day, and they have team shirts, and
you're going to have to bust that team up then. You have to draft. You're going to have to draft next year. We're going to bust that team up. Okay, thank you. It sounded like it was fun, and they were having a good time of fellowship with it to get ready for the year. Okay, Justin.
Okay, we had a sub-trade on August the 5th. We had 6 people that are now trained to be subs, and the majority of those have finished everything they need to. That we've been able to add those to our list. In your packet for this month, you've got a copy of the new ESSER survey, the updated version of the survey. We found out after the last board meeting, so the week after, we found out that now instead of being due this month, it's going to be due in September. So it gives us a little bit more of a cushion of time to go through and look at all those. And I think as of today, which was supposed to be the original closing date for our survey, we have over 120 responses, and the majority of those are As far as some technology stuff that we've got going on that's going to be new this year. So we've purchased a program called Go Guardian, which will be a safety tool for our classrooms, but also be a little bit of a classroom management tool as well. Our 7th and 8th grade teachers are going to be kind of piloting that for a couple of weeks so we can figure out kind of the ins and outs a little better before we roll it out school-wide. But essentially, it's a program where the teacher can have up on their screen, whether it's up on their board, or they can have up on their Chromebook or their desktop, that will show a seating chart and show every student in the room and what website, what tab they have open. The minute they change to something else, it shows them that too. So a positive to that is for the classroom, the teacher could has the control to, if they want to set it up to where, if we're going to be working with this specific website, I can lock it so that every child in the room is only on that website, can't go anywhere else. Or I can lock it where they can go anywhere they need to, except somewhere maybe that I don't want them going for the day. And they can even push out, like if mid-lesson the teacher decides, oh, I found something, I want everybody to go to this. And that'll be a positive, I think, not only for some classroom management things, but also as we roll it out some of our younger grades, it'll be easier than the teacher trying to put a URL up on the board and get everybody to type it in. They can just literally push it to every child from his computer to get them on where they need to go. So we're looking forward to what we can do with that. And then as far as some enrollment membership information, so we have some positive news on that. That our membership for K through 8, and of course we don't have our pre-K totally in the system yet, so this is just K through 8 numbers, we're at, for as of today, 662 students is what is showing in the system right now, and that is minus some that we know have transferred, we just haven't gotten records requests, and that is about 26 higher than what we had on this month last school year. And that's about 20 students higher than our highest month last school year. So we're very much in the positive on that. So that's some good news there. And then, of course, with our TBOS information that Ms. Burgett shared with you, that is now publicly available and is able to be viewed statewide. Also had one of our, it wasn't a superintendent, but it was one of the organizations that we work with that made a comment when they saw our percentages also. So we're getting noticed as far as how well we did on the test this year, how well our students did, how well the teachers were able to get the students to perform. And keep in mind, as you look at that public information that's showing out there, it shows those school-wide numbers and those system-wide numbers. And sometimes there's a question of why is the number different between school and system? And the way the state does those calculations, I remind teachers this every year, the way the state does those calculations is if you're looking at, say, for instance, fifth grade math or fifth grade science, when you're looking at the school level, it's the average of every school that has fifth grade math or fifth grade science. And so you're talking about hundreds of schools. So when they figure out the range of how that growth looks, it's based upon how that performed out of hundreds, versus on the system version of that, it's looking at just the total number of systems in the state that have fifth grade. They all have fifth grade, but some, you know, don't have high school like us. So that can vary, so you'll see a variance there. And also keep in mind that when you look at those numbers, that performance that we have for each grade level incorporates not only the regular ed classroom, but also any special populations in that as well. So you're not always looking at just an individual teacher there. Sometimes you're looking at multiple teachers and how that factors in together. But that's all I have.
Any questions? One thing I have is next meeting, September 19th. And then we have the fall district. Is also, it's the 22nd, isn't it? 27th, and it's at Jefferson County. It's at the Academy. I think they're doing that at the Academy.
I haven't heard you.
It's the high school.
I thought it was the high school. But
okay.
They have an auditorium there.
Let me
call
them.
They built that new auditorium. They did after that crash, they caved in, the roof caved in. they built a new theater area and character, okay, so they're gonna do it there. Okay. Was it the academy, Wednesday, maybe that's why I thought that. I think the fall district is the 27th, our east, which is at Jeff.
You're signed up for it.
Right, but our meeting will be the 19th. That's the third Monday. Is there any conflict with that?
That's my birthday.
Do what?
My birthday.
Oh, well, okay, it's the national holiday.
Yeah.
It's pretty happy birthday.
I'm not sure.
You better think.
Justin, you.
Is that not also when the superintendents have something, it's Murfreesboro or Franklin, those 3 days also? So you won't be in town possibly.
Yes, it is, because it's Thomas, I think.
So you're not gonna be here on the 19th?
No, let me stay here. I think that's right, the 19th, no, I'm gonna be at Thomas in Gatlinburg for 4 days. But I guess I could, you know, I can have everything planned for you if you wanna go on with it.
Do you sign?
Yeah, I can do whatever, I can do 12.
Do we wanna move it up to the 12?
Yeah.
I mean, we can move it to the 12th, that's just gonna shorten our time in between. I mean, the things that I always worry about, it's still 4 weeks, I agree, but the thing I always worry about is frankly, it's the federal stuff.
Now, we're good because the budget's not due till October 1, and then you all won't get it till they approve it at the state level, so we're okay with that.
So do we wanna move it to the 12th? That gives us a break too, that we're not meeting one that week and then the next week's fall district, okay. So we will, is there anybody here from the paper? Okay, thank you, I'm sorry. Then the paper can put that in there, so that'll make our announcement that it'll be the 12th. Instead of the 19th. And then fall district, if we've got that for fall district. So, but I don't have anything else.
I'm gonna ask a question.
Okay, go ahead.
About the mowing that we're gonna vote on is that's just for the remainder of this season, mowing season.
Yes, if you want to, or if you want it a year from now, you know, starting now for a year, how do you wanna do it either way? It can go for a year.
We need to decide.
It's pretty flexible.
For a year, or we wanna just for 2022?
You wanna make it for a year and then vote in the next year in August?
Well, we would either have to let this go for a year and redo it in, well, actually less than a year, well, August. Or we could let it go just for the 2022 year. And then in March.
Usually it goes through July 1st.
It usually does go from whatever day we sign the contract to July 1. And then we have the option to push it on for another year. And then just rebid it every 2 years is what we have. Past presidents.
That's what we've been doing, is just going.
Why don't we go to July 1st, is what we've got here, we're gonna vote on tonight. And then cut bids next, whatever day, for.
Yeah, June. May or June, take it, and then that would bid it, because the person that has it now would carry it through June 30th. And then we'd have a new, if it happened to be a new person, July 1.
Well, we would have that price locked in for the rest of the fiscal year.
What you all have allowed in the past, you know, you don't vote on it every year.
Right, we have the option to just go 2 years.
And I'm not, and I know it's a conflict of interest right here, but usually it's, we've been extending it for 3 years with that mower, the Suggs man that we had before. Do you remember Billy Suggs? We just kept extending it for 3 years. And then TNT had it, and they.
They just reneged on the contract, he just left the contract.
And so, you know, you can go to.
He just opted out of the contract, because he couldn't.
Yeah, you can go to June the 30th, and then you can decide to renew it or put it back up for votes.
That way, I mean, it wouldn't be any argument the same way, you just, you know, about the conflict of interest.
Yeah.
Somebody saying, well, you just did that because of this, you know.
It's fine with me, I don't know, whatever.
There's quite a bit of difference in the price, and you know, I keep seeing, you know, that go the other route, but, like I say, keep people, you know, from saying, well, you're just doing it because of who it is. Understand what I mean? I don't mean anything.
Yeah, I get it.
Okay. Nathan, anything?
Nope.
David? Sam?
I was just gonna commend our teachers and administration and staff, students for their, all their points on the test. Also kudos to you guys for all the work y'all did for the in-service week. I know it's a pretty intensive week for everybody, and that was a great job. And I know we got some folks, some leadership here in the back. Glad y'all are here. Might be a little bit more boring than the county commission, maybe not. Thank y'all for being here. And thank y'all for being involved in that program. It's a good program. I was in 2010. Amy, you were in 2006.
2006.
And so it's a really good program, and appreciate y'all doing that.
Did not expect that. Is there a press release that can go out for our scores, I mean, for our school? Is it an official press release that goes out, or no?
We did something last year, but that's more the exemplary district, I think, was it not?
We'll find something out later in September.
Okay.
About if, like, if we have like a school designation or district designation, like what we got last year. So maybe as part of that, if we get something on, we don't know if we will.
If not, then I would still do it. Does the DOE do a press release on this kind of stuff?
Yeah.
That's what I was asking. Is there something?
Fingers crossed. We did just as well as before that we might get that same status, but there's no way to know.
Well, we're hoping we're gonna get that same.
Right, but they are.
Those scores, we should.
But the DOE is who will send that out.
They'll put something.
Okay.
And it's in, later.
And then maybe the board could put stuff in congratulations.
Well, that's what I was going for, but I didn't wanna, I didn't know if we could yet. You know how all this stuff's embargoed, and then it's released, and then it's not.
Maybe we could do, then maybe we could do a picture of all of the staff, and then the kids, you know, get them all in the gym, and have a large picture.
Get them outside, do a drone picture.
Do like an advertise, do something saying the Newport City School Board really congratulates. Has, I mean.
Steve's got one. I know Derek's got one too.
One thing I'm wondering, and I don't know, I've not talked to Michael and Justin, Amy and Justin, but if we, yeah, I think it would be nice to do something for our whole school in celebration and recognition, and maybe even buy ice cream for all of the kids one day, you know, something. Since we're doing it for the staff and everything, the kids are who has helped us get there.
That's right. The kids are the ones that took that test.
And maybe we could do like ice cream, maybe we'd have the cafeteria, ice cream on us, you know, or something.
And I will say that our staff has already started to meet with our children this year and sit down and say, now this is what you've done on your GCAP test last year. And I know that Connor sat down and they said, well, look here, if you get one more question right, you're here next year instead of here. So I know they're already having conversations with students. They help students to goal set and to come up with a plan for academic achievement for the year, which I think is awesome.
We'll work on that when it comes out.
Right.
I'll have a big picture.
Right. That's what I...
And we'll celebrate the high
school. I kind of feel like when I looked here, because, you know, he really does a really good job of...
I know it. I've already discussed it.
Do those things.
I've already discussed it with him.
So that's why I was kind of looking at you to see what we could put out. But again, and I know we can't say thank you enough for what you've done. And it takes all of you, from admin down to the custodians, keeping it clean and keeping it safe where we got the kids here. We'll move on into the meeting. We'll stand behind me in the order. I pledge allegiance to the flag in the United States of America, to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Okay, first thing on the agenda is the consent agenda to approve the July 18th meeting minutes. I have a motion by Seth. Do I have a second?
Second.
Nathan with a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Moving into the business agenda, and we will follow suit as we made last meeting. to approve all of the procedures in one lump vote with a second reading. So bear with me as I go through all of the numbers, but we have the TSB administrative procedures, the second reading of policy 1.407.1, policy 3.202.4, policy 4.101.1, policy 4.210.1, policy 4.212.1, policy 4.402.2, policy 4.403.2, policy 4.406.5, policy 4.406, that's on there twice. No, it says online courses or online resources, but it's got the exact same number. So complaints regarding digital or online courses, and then policy 4.406.5, complaints regarding digital or online resources. Policy 5.119.1, policy 5.310.1, policy 5.310.2, policy 6.200.4, policy 6.200.5, policy 6.304.3, policy 6.409.1, policy 6.415.1, and policy 6.505.3. Do I have a motion?
Make a motion.
I have Mickey with a motion. I have Seth with a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. Travel for Amy Messer. I have four different travels. We'll do them all together. I have ESEA ESSER Conference in Franklin, August 31st through the 1st. Literacy Association of Tennessee Conference in Murfreesboro, December 4th through the 6th. AirVet Law Legal Education Conference, Pigeon Forge, September 22nd through the 23rd, and Special Ed Supervisors Meeting in Hawkins County on September 13th. Do I have a motion?
Motion.
A motion of Nathan. Do I have a second?
Second.
David with a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Nathan with a motion. David with a second. Travel for Sandra Burchett. We have three different ones. ESEA ESSER Conference in Franklin, August 31st through the 1st. Literacy Association of Tennessee Murfreesboro, December 4th through the 6th. Superintendent Study Council, there are several dates for that. That's August 7th, September 21st, October 19th, November 16th, December 21st of 2022. And then we go into January 18th, February 15th, March 15th, April 19th, May 17th and June 21st of 2023. Do I have a motion?
Motion.
I have Mickey with a motion. Do I have
second.
A second? Nathan with a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Michelle Black, travel. CSH Professional Development, August 15th and November 15th. RHAT Conference, November 16th through the 17th. Excuse me, 16th through the 18th. Thank you. CSH Professional Development, January 17th. CSH Institute, March 26th through the 29th. CSH Professional Development on April 11th. Do I have a motion?
Motion.
Seth with a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
David with a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Travel for Michael Short, AirVet Law Legal Education Conference, September 22nd and 23rd. Do I have a motion?
Motion.
David with a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Nathan with a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Facility use. We have the Girl Scouts requesting to use the NGS facility on August 25th for a meet and greet. Mr. Short has waived the cost for the use of the facility, but proof of insurance must be provided. Do I have a motion?
Motion.
Nathan with a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Mickey with a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Boy Scouts requesting to use the facility, NGS facility on September 1st. Mr. Short has waived the use of the facility, but proof of insurance to be provided. Do I have a motion?
Motion.
Mickey with a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Nathan with a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Field trips, kindergarten to to the zoo on September 16th. Transportation on a Cobb County school bus. Cost will be $16. Do we have a motion?
Motion.
Nathan with a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
Seth with a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Move on to fundraising. I going too fast?
No, I asked him if he was going. He told me his was in first grade, not kindergarten.
Fundraising, pre-K through second grade resource classes requesting approval to sell Krispy Kreme donut vouchers to assist for paying for their Christmas trip. Cost will be $10 a voucher. Motion?
Motion.
Thinking that was Nathan?
Mm-hmm.
Second?
Second.
Mickey with a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Cheerleaders requesting a hat day September 2nd. Proceeds will go to help pay for the cost of a day camp. Cost for $1. Motion?
Motion.
Mickey with a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Nathan with a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Sponsors of the new cooking club, Gene Delisle and Emily McConaughey, are requesting the board's approval for hat day fundraiser August 26th towards the operation of the club, and the cost will be $1 per child per hat. Motion?
Motion.
Seth with the motion.
Second. Motion
second. Do I have a second?
Second.
Nathan with a second. All in favor?
Any
opposed? To piggyback on the new cooking club, the sponsors of the cooking club are requesting a $15 fee to help with the purchase of supplies for the students that are joining. Do I have a motion?
Motion.
Nathan with the motion. Do I have a second?
Is this a fee the students would pay?
Yes. It would be a fee that the students would pay as part of that.
The kids that are selected.
Yes.
The selection process.
I'll second.
Nikki with a second. All in favor? Any opposed? Vote on the bid for mowing the school grounds. I need the name of the bid in your motion. I need the name and then.
I make a motion we accept earthwork at $750 per mowing, and that will be for till June the 29th, 2023.
Okay, Mickey has a motion for Merchant Earthwork bid for $750 per mowing, and that contract would end on 6/30/23. Do I have a second?
Second.
That's Seth with the second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Increasing the travel mileage to 62.5 cents per mile. Yes, Seth was a second. Retroactive to July 1st.
Damn Lord.
They're little, but they're good. They're little. I get made fun of them all the time with my little ears. My little head and little ears, but they hear well. And that is an IRS increase. The IRS increased the July 1st. Increase the rate from 58-something to 62.5. For our people that are traveling, we've asked for this mileage increase. Do I have a motion?
Motion.
Nathan with a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
David with a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Next on the agenda is a stipend to teachers receiving an individual TBOS score of 4 or 5. Teachers with a 5 will receive $1,000 minus benefits. Teachers receiving a 4 will receive $800 minus benefits. And this is the same as the board has approved in past years.
I make a motion.
Mickey with a motion.
Second.
Seth with the second. With it being money, do I need to do a roll call? I don't think so. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Board is also aware that it takes all the staff to make sure that our school is successful, so all of the staff may choose one of the following options in appreciation of the school-wide district score of 5. Full-time staff may choose to take 2 extra personal days during the 2022-2023 year or $300 minus benefits. Part-time staff may choose to take 1 extra personal day during the 2022-2023 school year or $150 minus benefits. And these incentives, again, are the same as the board has approved in past years. Do I have a motion?
Motion.
I have a motion by Seth, do I have a second?
Second.
Nathan with a second, all in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
The motion to adjourn?
I have anything for, I have a motion to adjourn by Seth.
Second.
Second by Nathan, all in favor?